Hello, thank you so much for your patience and your purchase of my special. I'm going to talk about what's blocking you financially, messages from spirit, and insight upon your love life. So let me connect with your energy. I'm seeing that this is going to be a really good time for you to do some self-reflecting. I'm hearing the peach. I don't know why, like, just see that things are peachy, like things are gonna be fine. Maybe you need to, like, maybe you need more sweet things within your life, or you need to feel more sweet about yourself. But overall, I feel like you will be okay. But let's see what's going on for you. Oh, got a card pop out? Okay. I feel like you need to be either the head of the household, or you need to take back your title. Fine, I keep picking up on like fruits and vegetables for you. Maybe this is what you need. Okay, insight upon love for you. So an extra card came out for blockages with finances. Okay, so this card came back. Wow. I feel like you need to have a strong grips upon your money. I feel that you are going through a very karmic time with your money, and you may discovering that you have lost something, whether you lost a job or more money is coming out. I do feel like you, a part of you feel as if you've lost grips, or you feel you feel like you aren't in control of your money, or you feel like someone is taking something from you. I do feel like there may be a shady person within your life involving finances, and they may be asking you for money, or they may be taking money from you. So just pay attention to your money and make sure that like no extra money is coming out. I feel like really interesting. This is definitely going to be a really good time for you to do some self-reflecting and take a look at yourself and see what can you do to change your finances. Because growth is trying to come in, and prosperity is trying to come in. But I do see that now it's all about your actions, and it's all about what are you going to do. Be aware of you relying on someone else, or you are just following through with someone else, because I do feel like there's going to be a sense of betrayal, or like this person, they aren't going to follow through with something. And I feel like you've dealt with this a lot, or like you had to take up someone else's slack while this person saved their money, or this person lied to you, and many times you received the shorter end of the stick. I feel like you definitely need to be mindful of a two-sided person. And I also feel like you need to mature a bit when it comes to your money. But things may seem a bit at odds with you, with your finances. Basically, I just feel like you need to gain a grip upon your money, who has control of your money, who you're giving your money to. And I also feel like your karma is affecting your money. So just be mindful if you're being negative with somebody, or if you're talking bad about somebody, because I feel like that can affect you, honestly. I feel like you need to be mindful of you being a yes man or man. I'm sorry, you being a yes ma'am, I wanted to say, to people when it's involving your money. Like, if you don't want to do something, then don't. Because I feel like you can be a bit of a, not really, maybe a pushover. Or like, maybe you just want to make people happy, and you just do things, you know, to benefit them. And I feel like you shouldn't do that. Because I also feel like you being submissive has affected your money, and it is affecting your money. So this is really tying in to like you being the head of household, like you being your own person, or like you just being in charge of something. So if someone, like, if do be aware of you paying someone else's bills or some, like, because I just feel like you are benefiting someone else and it's actually hurting you. So be careful of you being a yes ma'am, meaning like if somebody asks you something, you're always saying yeah, even if you don't want to do it. And just be mindful of your control upon your money. And do be careful of you speaking negatively about people or sending negative energy towards people. Messages from spirit. They want you to understand your growth. They want you to pay attention to them more. They want you to pay more attention to your intuition. They want you to just feel protected and know that you are. But I'm picking up that you or someone around you may be very hot-tempered or hot-headed during this time. I feel like this is going to be a really good time for you to be gentle with yourself and for you to love yourself or love children. Show appreciation towards the younger things in life, or show appreciation to situations that are still in process, like maybe relationships, like a new relationship, a new job. Maybe you're starting a garden and you are just seeing weeds right now. Like, just show appreciation towards things that are still blossoming, okay? I also feel that you need to be mindful of you feeling restricted and stuck. You honestly may be helping out someone and is not benefiting you. You need to be mindful of you being in your stuck in your own ways. I feel like in a past life you were a prisoner and kind of like an indentured servant. Because I don't feel like this was slavery. I just feel like this was more of a prisoner for a short time. And a part of you felt ashamed, and a part of you didn't like having to do what people told you to do. And I feel that you could have escaped it, like you could have escaped, but I feel like you were afraid to. I'm picking up that you were a white male in a past life. You were fairly handsome, you had brown hair. And I feel like this past life is kind of affecting you, because if you are doing things for people, even if you don't want to, and even if you know it's not good for you, pay attention to if you are doing this, because this is not good. And I feel like you need to break this past life by saying no. Okay? So no is a good word. It's a very good word. Because I feel like you are able to break free from these chains or this restriction, but it's just like either you are afraid to or you feel as if you can't. You better start today. All right, messages involving your love life. Romantic feelings. Soulmate. So if you are single or in a relationship, you may find yourself wanting these emotions, or you have that. I feel like with you, once again, take things slow. Yeah, your energy feels fairly single to me, to be honest. I feel like within this past life, I keep talking about past life. So you may find some, like a past lover may come back to you. I feel like not within this lifetime. I feel like a lover who you've had feelings with, like maybe within the 1500s, their energy is going to come back and they may be a soulmate. And you may feel like kind of love at first sight with this person, because I feel that like it's just going to feel just, I know you. Where have I've known you? Like, where have you been? I've missed you. Like, that's how the energy is gonna feel. But I do feel that like you need to be aware of this moving too fast, because I feel like it can, because the energy is going to feel very intense. Like, oh, we already know each other, so, you know, like, let's just do things that couple and married people already do. But I, like I said, I feel like you need to take things slow. The extra cards that came out was codependency. Very soon, give your relationship a chance. So I do feel like you are going to find love, beautiful love within this lifetime. But just take things slow. Be aware of any addiction issues going on, whether this is for you or for someone else. Always put yourself first, okay? And, you know, like, just be patient with the process of things. I said this earlier for you. Just be patient. Hopefully you enjoyed this message. Good luck with everything. And hopefully I hear from you soon. Take care. Bye.